During World War II, a lot of planes were left abandoned because of numerous circumstances, like being unable to fly or by crashing into a remote area. In Europe, most of these planes have been cleaned up, but in the Pacific you can still find multiple planes everywhere. Today there are a lot of planes and other vehicles left, but most of them were actually collected during the 1970s, when interest in aviation began to get traction, and it's pretty hard to imagine that before this you could find a landscape of untouched historical vehicles and planes left around several Pacific islands. And I always found this to be a really interesting subject, because you could not find anything like this in any other part of the world. So in this video I'm going to have a look at some of the abandoned planes that were actually salvaged and restored. One interesting place was Babo Airfield in Indonesia. This airfield was used by the Japanese and had at one point 14 abandoned aircraft, from Zeros to Betty's and Kawasaki aircraft. One that really stood out to me is this Zero, still with one of the starter trucks in its original position. You can also see the damage it took from the Allied bombings. Today, planes in this condition would be displayable for a museum without even restoring it. But today, most of these places are picked clean and most of the planes have gone to museums all over the world, restored to an amazing condition. But you can still find wrecks all over the place, like in Micronesia and the Solomon Islands. But in the last few years, more attention has been given to these wrecks because of the value, but also because of the long-term effects the vehicles have on nature and the exploded ordnance have on the groundwater. If one does only a simple Google search, you will be amazed in what you will find, like these tanks that were dumped by the Allies in Micronesia, and I'm talking about 20 so Japanese Argo tanks, and that's not counting the ones that are left underwater. Still, this can all be found in a collection spot where they were dumped after the war. But with these things becoming more popular, you can literally see the parts disappear in each picture. Another interesting place is Colonia Airfield in Jap Island, and today this place has the most numerous intact Zeros left in the world, still left where they were abandoned more than 70 years ago. As far as I can find the information, there are still 6 Zeros and other aircraft left in and around the island, and even a Boeing 727 that crash landed here in the 1980s. The Zero was a long-range fighter aircraft developed by Mitsubishi Aircraft Company in 1939. The Zero was designated as the Mitsubishi Navy Type Zero carrier fighter, but would be referred to by its pilots as the Ryzen. The Allies called it Zeke, but would also be referred to as Zero from time to time. In the early days of the war, the Zero would be vastly known as the best carrier-based fighter in the world, and would be an exceptional dogfighter because of its excellent maneuverability and very long range. but by 1934, apparent weaknesses and design flaws began to show, and the Zero began to be less effective against new Allied aircraft, and it would be outdated by 1944. But if you want to know more about the Zero, Military Aviation History did a great video that you can find on his channel. Some of the Zeros now in the collection of the Kawaguchiko Motor Museum in Urasawa in Japan came from Colonia Airfield, and one of the restored Mitsubishi A6M5 Zeros was restored with parts from a Zero with serial number 1493 and is now on display at Yasukan. Yasukan likes to claim they restored it for the glorious anniversary of Yasukuni Shrine, but since everything in this museum needs to be taken with a large grain of salt, and watch my Yasukan Worst Museum on the Planet video on that one. Another aircraft that was recovered from Colonia Airfield is the D4Y Susei Model 11 Navy Dive Bomber. The D4Y, named by the Allies' duty, was a two-seat carrier-based dive bomber developed by Yokosuko Naval Air Technical Arsenal in the 1940s. It was originally designed as a dive bomber, but it would be used as a reconnaissance plane, night fighter, and in special attack units like the Kamikaze. The D4Y was presumably one of the last planes to be used in a kamikaze attack hours after the surrender of Japan. With Admiral Motome Yugagi from the Imperial Japanese Navy on board, and Yugagi apparently heard the Japanese surrender on the radio, but wrote in his diary, noting that he not yet received any official ceasefire order, and that he alone was to blame for the failure of his valiant aviators to stop the enemy. He would fly one last mission himself to show the true spirit of Bushido. The Yokosuka D4Y that's now on display in the main hall of the Yasukuni Museum was discovered in 1972 in the jungles alongside Colonia Airfield. The plane was eventually salvaged with the cooperation of the Nippon Television Network and Mr. Endo Nibuhiko in the 1980s. They restored the plane at the Kisarazu Ground Self Defense Force Base, and all this would be broadcasted as a TV special. During the restoration, they used several parts from other D4Y planes found on Jap Island, and all this was pretty much new for Japanese television, because a full-scale restoration like this was never done before, and proved to be an amazing challenge. And for something that was done back in Japan at that time, is pretty amazing, because they restored this plane to working order in a few months. Sadly, it's hard to find the actual footage of this TV program, and only a few pictures from several magazines can be found online. I also can't find any information if it actually flew at the end of this series. Today the engine has been removed for the purpose of displaying it, and I wonder if it would actually run again after so long. Both planes look in an amazing condition, and a lot of effort went into their restoration, and if my sources are right, the Zero from the Narasawa Motor Museum isn't even done yet, and at this point they are restoring a Zero plane to running condition, and maybe they will eventually do that with this plane too. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I know it's a challenging time for people, and I wish you all a good bit of health. And I hope I can make some extra videos for you guys with all the free time I have now. So keep safe and see you in the next one.